going on, everybody? It's Jets Central coming back with some breaking NFL news that literally happened like 3 minutes ago involving the Cincinnati Bengals and the Buffalo Bills. Now, they pulled off a huge trade right now, and as a Jets fan, not going to lie to you guys, I'm nervous as hell because the Cincinnati Bengals acquired left tackle Cordy and the 21st overall draft pick in exchange for the 12th pick in the NFL draft. And like I said, as a Jets fan, all signs are pointing that the Buffalo Bills are going to move up into the top five and snag a quarterback. They trade Tyrod Taylor for a pick. They have two firsts, two seconds, two third-round picks. Their only quarterback on the roster right now is Nathan Peterman. They're not going after Cousins. And right now, I'm pretty sure that they're not going to go after Drew Brees. So all indications are pointing that the Buffalo Bills have their sights set on one or two guys in the top five, and they're making a move and going up and getting him, okay? This trade reminds me a lot of back in 2016 when the Eagles, I think they moved up to 8, and then they moved up again to 2 to go get Carson Wentz. Back in 2016. So, huge trade. And, you know, like I said, as a Jets fan, I'm not in the best of moods right now because the Buffalo Bills, if the Bills jump us to go get their quarterback and we miss out on one, along with missing out on Kirk Cousins, then that would just be a total slap in the face to the franchise. It really, or not the franchise, but the fan base. I mean, this is just, it's unacceptable if that goes down. But in regards to what the Cincinnati Bengals got, you know, big picture, they upgraded left tackle. You know, Cordy Glenn's coming in and is immediately a upgrade, okay? Cordy Glenn is still a beast. I know he's kind of up there in age, but he's still a great player. So the Bengals are getting a huge upgrade at left tackle, a position of need. I mean, I've seen a lot of people project a left tackle to the Bengals at spot number 12. I don't think you could have gotten one better than Cordy Glenn at 12. So you're upgrading at that position, and then of course you are getting another, or you're technically moving back in the draft to pick number 21. So you can still get an impact player. You know, so I really don't know. I mean, I was kind of thinking Derwin James to the Cincinnati Bengals early, but now at 21, I don't think he's going to be there at all. So it's, you know, I guess I'm going to have to like look at, you know, the Bengals roster and whatnot. But, you know, big picture right now, the Bengals are upgrading at left tackle. They also acquired a for extra pick, you know, so they're not like completely out of the loop as far as the first rounders go. And then the Bills obviously went up to 12, getting rid of a left tackle, so there is going to be a hole to fill there, but it's obvious this team wants a quarterback and they're moving up. I really don't know how many more signs or indications that Bills can give, you know, us fans that they're going to do it. You know, I just feel like it's obvious. They are telling us right now they are moving up to the top five, and they're just sweetening the deal. You know, from moving from 20 instead of 21 and 22, now it's 22 and 12. You know, that's huge as far as negotiations go. So, again, bad news for the Jets fans out there. But yeah, good news for the Bengals. You know, you're staying in the first round and you're upgrading left tackle. So, and obviously great news for the Buffalo Bills moving up that far for a player that they wanted to get rid of. So that's the breaking news. Let me know down in the comment section your guys' thoughts on this move from the Bengals side, the Bills side, and of course the Jets side, like always. So with that being said, thanks so much for watching, and go Jets.